So poor old Evan got very dusty cleaning up all the bits of glass that I got covered in. I don't have the right fittings for this compressor, but I'm dying to use it for something. So we're going to use it to blow off Evan. Cleaning now, Evan.
Yeah.
So in this video, we're going to be starting to build the power sword, or the sword of Grayskull from He-Man. There's all different versions of the sword because it's an animation. It's prone to changing sizes and proportions and all that stuff. So there's two data points that I'm basing this on. Is one, me and the customer discussed, and if you were getting someone to play He-Man, he'd have to at least be as big as The Rock, and The Rock is 6'5" or something like that. I can't remember what height he is, but that's the height we picked. So then scaling it from the like various pieces of He-Man art I found, I arrived on this length for the sword, and then the actual proportions of the sword and stuff, I found a piece of concept art by a guy called Fred Carrillo, who worked on the original show. So that's where I know there's loads of different versions of the power sword, and it looks different in different things. But this is the version I'm basing it on. And the thing that makes the He-Man sword iconic in my mind is the fact that it has this weird, like non-guard, where it has these like weird cavities. And I actually think that's based on a misinterpretation of the way the plastic toy was. Like, I think the plastic toy had like a more traditional guard where these were like separate pieces, or it was supposed to, and then they realized that it was easier for mold purposes to join these together, and then whoever was working on the show, because the toys came first, then like super stylized that mold error, I guess you'd call it, and then just totally went for it, and it became like, it makes it different looking to other swords. So that's what I'm going to be copying. Not the more, I saw there was like a piece of promotional material for the new show, and they used the other type of He-Man sword where it was like a separate ones. And I'm only able to mention the TV show because I kind of forgot to film this intro before I had the sword actually made. And so I didn't even know that that TV show was going to come out when they started making it. Nova! It's probably still too thick to twist off. Yeah, not a budge. Ooh. Paradox, man. It's tough stuff. Did move a little bit. Whew. Fine. even without taking away this material, I like doing this because now I can go to the line with the more aggressive stuff. And in case a spot of heat or something goes bloop and wrecks my outline. Well, it can't wreck my outline because now the what I'm aiming for is locked in by grinding. But you can see all that excess material I have to take off. So that's the edge, those parts rounded off. But here, when I'm cutting an edge, I always try to angle it away, because obviously this side, the template was marked on this side, and what I don't want is to cut in this direction. So I have to die ground this part away, this much away, all around, all along the edge. It's not normally so clear and evident what has happened. The metal dust makes the wood dust catch on fire, but it takes way longer to cut out a half inch blank than it does a quarter inch blank. Like I would say, twice as long. So on some versions of the power sword, it's this shape is rendered as sunk in. And then it's the same level as the rest of the sword, but it's sunk in and then rises to this ridge. And then some other ones render the sword as having, this is just a separate plate slapped on top. Now I think, after looking at the concept art that I found, that it basically was just meant to be a plate on top, but it looks so slick having it recessed. And I think we could maybe do both. Like maybe we could carve out this shape and then sink a separate plate into this shape. So that's what I want to attempt to do. So this guy, which I need to use next, wasn't working. It was rotating loose like this just fine, but then when it had air attached, it would seize up when the trigger was you could hear air hissing, but it was just all locked, not moving at all up here. So I took it apart and just examined it and couldn't find anything that might come even close to causing that. So I just put it back together again and now it's working. So who knows, some little piece of crud I didn't notice. But yeah, it's a mysterious, sometimes it's mysterious, like you just take a thing apart and put it back together again, you're still left with no answer but the result you wanted. So I started to think about using the air tool on this guy, but then I realized it wasn't going to work at all, because if the slope, I'm drawing this upside down now, came down like this, and I wanted a plate to sit into the recess, I would have to take the edge off the plate to get down to the bottom, and by the time I got down to the bottom, I might have to take a large amount off the plate. It might wind up looking silly. It's actually, if I want the edge to be sharp, it to have like a 90 degree at the edge, the easiest way to accomplish that, like I even thought about like maybe making a different die grinder rig with a small the pencil grinder so I could take out the edge, but the more I thought about it, the more silly it got, especially the taking out all the middle to the appropriate level. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take out all of this section, like just remove it completely, and then after I remove it, put in a different plate, an 1/8 inch plate in the middle, and that way there'll be a flat thing for the two insert plates I want to put in there to sit on, which seems nutty. But that was the result of all the calculations I did about how much time it would take to clean up an edge to 90 degrees and make a big recess. It's just easier to take out everything here, which seems insane, but that was the answer I kept coming up with when I was doing the calculations. Thank you. Huh. I don't know, is it obvious that that's cut through largely, except for at the corner parts, which are very annoying. Is it more obvious if I do this? And stuff, but I'm wondering, like, I have a couple of backup plans of how I could do the other bits. There's lots of dust in that crack. But I wonder, would a metal cutting jigsaw blade get it actually? So I tried them. There's no slow setting on the jigsaw. It just kind of goes. And the Hardox really did a number on these teeth. Like, in seconds, it like damaged them a lot. Oh my god, that smoke. I'm burning something over there, the other place. And the smoke is getting in my eyes. The hacksaw is working a bit, but it's a pain in the butt. So I might give up and then go to Operation Big Giant Mess. For the moment, it's hacksaw o'clock. I have lots of hacksaw blades. See, I'm there now. Track my progress. So I just did the calculation and it took 4 hacksaw blades to get in as far as there from here. And so even with this big giant pile of hacksaw blades, I don't have enough to do it. So we're gonna have to go to Operation Big Giant Mess. The next part of Operation Giant Mess is the plasma cutter with a completely fresh head, even though it's not supposed to cut stuff this thick, and very careful cutting procedure. Oh my god! Whatever else you want to say about Operation Giant Mess, it certainly happened. I think the Nurgle sword was the last time I used this for cutting out sword parts. Why is the sea so garbage? I gotta sort this out, it's not behaving right. It was the air pressure! The air pressure was set sky high! Yeah, so if you run into problems yourself, 5 to 7 in the acetylene, 13 pounds of pressure in the oxygen. Yeah, I don't know why it was set sky high. It must have been like using the air hose to blow something out or some crap. I don't know why it was so high.
when I was in Australia, this chisel was given me by a fella called Troy. He wanted to give me a knife. I told him if he gave me a chisel, it would actually be more likely that I'd use it than a knife. This is more just a way of saying, see, look, I told you. Chisel is way more likely to wind up in my video than one of your knives. What does he call himself? Nora Knives? Nora? Nora? Nora. Maybe that's it. Anyway. Thank you for the chisel! So that was the mop disc. What's that? Is that oil from this Scotch-Brite? Ugh, I think it is. Thought I'd got a clean one, but maybe I hadn't. So that was the 7-inch in a 9-inch grinder sandpaper. And then a smaller one, same thing. And then one of those interleaf flap discs. And then I went down with these things that the when I was in Australia, I was talking to the Norton boys, and they gave me these rapid blend. They're just Scotch-Brite discs. They can withstand the normal rotation of the grinder, coarse, medium, fine, and they just smoothed everything out. I don't think they're supposed to remove material. Like, this was the last one to remove material, and then this one just kind of, these three just kind of squished everything together. Wanted to know how hard it would be to get it down to a surface that you can Scotch-Brite, because once this, I have to drill holes and weld on top of the holes and stuff when this goes in. But I just wanted to know how difficult it was going to be to bring it back. And so I don't think it's going to be that hard to get it back to the way it's supposed to be. Now the camera is standing where I want to stand. Oh. But that's the idea. Little edge checker. Cut to me standing here.
The mighty algorithm continues to command that I break my projects up into 20-minute chunks if I want to continue eating. There should be a box on the screen with a link to a playlist of all the parts of this build video that have been uploaded thus far. If all the parts of the build video haven't been uploaded yet, they'll be uploaded once a week until they are all there. Alternatively, if you want to see the whole length video right now, it's up on my Patreon. There should be a link somewhere around. The whole thing's up there, the furry underpants, the whole thing. If for some reason YouTube has changed its thing again, and there's no box floating with a link to the playlist of all the parts, there'll be a link in the description.